Tales from the Crypt. Damn you, Marcel! I told you they wanted violence, not violins. Good help is so hard to find, isn't it, kiddies? Want a little more champagne? I hope you're hungry for tonight's murderous menu. It concerns a man who's discovered that the fastest way to a woman's heart is with a pickaxe. I call this tasty little hors d'oeuvre None But the Lonely Heart.
Is Madame ready for dinner?
Oh.
I hope you're hungry. Here you go. Just a quiet little dinner for two.
Oh.
And voila!
Howard, it's beautiful.
Oh, it's just a little something I threw together.
Oh.
And to go with it, I thought we'd have this bottle of the 1966 Chateau Lafite Rothschild.
Well, I thought we were saving that for a special occasion.
Well, we're having dinner together. That's special enough for me.
Oh.
To you, my darling.
Thank you. That's quite good.
You know, there's a complexity to great wine that only comes with age. It tastes of everything that's touched it. The grapes, the soil, the oak in which it fermented, and in the end, your lips.
Oh, Howard, you do know my heart.
I hope you don't mind my bringing up business, darling, but I think it's rather important. There's a small company I want to invest in, but I'm afraid we're going to have to act quickly.
Howard, I told you whatever you think.
And I told you that I won't do it that way. As far as I'm concerned, this is your money. I'm merely managing it for you. All right?
Where do I sign?
All right, you sign here.
Okay.
That's right. And here.
And now, I think you should do something for me. Oh, no, no, no. You know.
Ah. All of it? Or just your favorite part? Yet at my back, I always hear time's winged chariot hurrying near. The grave's a fine and private place. Yet none, I think, do there embrace. Now, therefore, while velvet hue sits on thy skin like morning dew, and while thy willing soul transpires. Ashamed to have wasted such a great bottle of wine. Yes, yes, I need an ambulance right away. It's my wife. I think she's having a heart attack.
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust, in the sure and certain hope of the resurrection and to eternal life. Amen.
Amen. Sleep well, my beautiful Rose.
I'm very sorry.
Thank you.
You made her last month special, Howard. You really did.
Well, thank you, Megan. I appreciate
it. She loved you, Howard. How she loved you. If you need anything, call me, okay?
Ah, yes, you gave her so much, and she gave it all back.
What the fuck are you doing here, Morty?
I gotta hand it to you, Howard. You're good. You've got these people completely fooled.
As a matter of fact, I was very fond of Matilda. She was a wonderful woman. So was Elizabeth. So was Claire, for that matter.
Shame they had to be killed.
That was business, Morty. Now, I could have taken the money and run, left them all destitute. Now, that would have been cruel. I do these ladies a very big favor.
Yeah.
I make them feel loved.
Yeah. As your business partner, it's my unfortunate duty to give you some bad news. The IRS froze $1 million of our assets this morning.
God damn it!
Hey, tip of the iceberg. Say goodbye to Howard and Morty, Inc. They also pushed up our day before the grand jury, so I called some of the airlines.
No, we're not going anywhere. We are not ready, Morty.
What not ready? We got $5 million. More or less. I say we liquidate and get our assets to someplace that's got good year-round weather and no extradition treaty. There's this island I know called, Escuncheon. Escuncheon.
Morty, the whole plan was to set ourselves up for life. In this economy, $2 million will not do that job.
We're in danger. In 11 days, we face a grand jury. When they uncover this little Ponzi scheme of ours...
Okay, give me 10 days. The plan was to score one more old lady, and that's exactly what I plan to do.
10 days?
Yeah.
They're gonna nail your ass, pal. And when they do, I'd like to be just as far away as possible.
Well, trust me, Morty. You won't regret it.
Yeah, right.
Pro wrestling and bowling. I still bowl. It's very good exercise. And I like the noise. And they...
My name is Effie Gluckman. I'm 67 years old. And I'm not looking for a suitor. I was married for 38 years to a wonderful man. I don't think there's anyone out there who could replace Theodore, so...
Theodore. Big Teddy Gluckman. Wow, 2 pages. Impressive. Teddy was busy.
I would rather that be understood from the start. What I want is a companion.
Check out the gems. Check out the gems. Are they real?
Is real.
Yes. Oh, yes, it's real. $30,000 at least.
A friend, really. Someone to share things with. I mean, how many times can one see Paris alone?
Ah, any luck, Mr. Prince?
3245, Effie Gluckman.
Effie Gluckman. Oh, yes, another mature woman. But they do give a man something special, don't they? Well, I hope it works out for the both of you.
I'm sure it will.
I tried to tell the young man there'd been some error, but he insisted on seeing you himself. Shall I show him out, madam?
In a minute, Stanhope.
Mr. Prince? Nothing personal, Mr. Prince, but to be perfectly honest with you, I had in mind someone a little closer to my own age. I mean, what would an attractive young man like you want with...
An older woman, like you? Aside from the money. That is what you mean, isn't it?
The thought had crossed my mind, yes.
I'm going to be very honest with you. I don't need your money. I could show you a bank book, but I think we'd both agree that that would be somewhat tasteless. And as for attractive young ladies my own age, I'm afraid that that kind of beauty is wasted on me. You see, women like that have certain needs that I'm unable to fulfill.
Stanhope, thank you.
I'll be nearby if you need me, madam.
Mr. Prince, are you saying that you're...
All I want from a woman is companionship. Because, after all, no one wants to see Paris alone. I never truly learned to appreciate women until I stopped thinking about them in that way.
You know what your trouble is, Howard. You've spent your whole life pursuing the wrong kind of woman.
And that's what I saw in you, Effie. Not just a woman, but a kind of goddess. Effie, I know exactly what you mean.
My husband, Theodore, had your condition when he met me.
Really? He was impotent too?
He was handsome and wealthy, but wounded in that way. You remind me of him. But you seem so much more passionate, more alive. Well, of course you are. I never thought I'd feel this way about another man, but...
Oh, look at the time. I must have kept you from a thousand things. Thank you for talking to me, Effie.
Howard, why don't you stay for dinner?
Oh, I really couldn't.
No. Please. Please. I insist. Stanhope!
Shall I show the gentleman to the door, madam?
I want you to set two places for dinner.
But there's not enough lamb.
What?
Not enough lamb.
Make extra rice. And use the good china.
Surely not the good silver as well.
I want everything to be perfect. Here, put this in a vase. Jigsaw puzzles were Theodore's passion. He spent 6 years on that one. In fact, he died right at that table. The puzzle is exactly as he left it.
I've always found jigsaw puzzles to be an incredible waste of time.
Me too. Howard, I've known men twice your age who didn't have half your worldliness. I can help you.
Effie.
I can remedy your condition.
Really, we shouldn't. We have all the time in the world.
Not when you're my age, you don't. Just relax, my darling. I'll be gentle. Howard, I made you breakfast in bed. For some reason, this morning, I have a hell of an appetite.
Effie, listen, about last night, I mean... Not since college, not even in college.
Don't say anything. I feel great. I haven't felt this good in years.
Well, just don't expect that from me every night, all right?
Oh, this came for you this morning.
Really?
Mm. Who's it from?
Hmm? It's, business. I have to skip breakfast. I'm sorry.
Oh. You're coming back, aren't you?
Effie, of course. If you'll have me.
been doing here?
You know, I could ask you the same question, Morty. What are you doing here?
What does it look like? Getting ready to blow this pop set.
Kind of premature, aren't you?
Did anyone see you come in here? You know, we really shouldn't be seen together.
What were you going to do, Morty? Take the money and run? Leave me holding the bag?
All those wives are starting to rub off on you, pal. You're babbling.
Come on, Morty. You know, you lie like you dress badly. Take that tie, for instance. You know that doesn't go with your shirt?
Thanks for the fashion tip.
You're welcome. Howard Prince.
Oh, I can't tell you how much fun that was. I know you wanted to wait, but I thought, why? This morning when I woke up, all I wanted to do was go to City Hall and get married.
Will the happy couple be having lunch in the dining room for a change?
No, I think we'll be having it in bed as usual. Hmm. Oh, Howard, come. Now sit. I have a little wedding present for you. Yesterday, I called the bank and told them to change the titles on all the accounts. All it needs is your signature.
Now, Effie, I told you not to do that.
Now, don't be angry with me. If managing my money gives you pleasure, I want you to do it. I love you, Howard. Now, I'm going upstairs to start the jacuzzi, and when it's full and bubbly, I'll expect to find you in it.
This arrived for you, sir, while you were celebrating the nuptials. Congratulations, I'm sure, for this wonderful moment.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, Mr. Prince, hi. I didn't hear you come in.
Yeah, excuse me. I thought when I owned the place, I'd never have to clean the head, but...
You take a real personal interest in your clients, don't you, Perkins?
Well, yeah.
What was it you said about older women?
Well, I don't remember saying anything.
You said they give a man something special. You said that, didn't you?
Well, I could have, yes.
Is that what you find criminal?
Look,
Mr. Prince!
What I find criminal? Blackmail. Hi, sweetheart. Listen, I'm sorry I had to run out on you like that, but something came up. I want you to do me a favor. I want you to give Stanhope the night off. Because I'm going to make dinner for us both tonight, that's why. That's right. Just you and me and a nice bottle of wine. La 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 la
la la la la la la. Does the name Matilda Mason mean anything to you?
I thought I gave you the night off.
How about Elizabeth Swarthmore? Or Claire McCarthy? Shall I go on? It seems, sir, there is something of a pattern to your past.
What's your point, Stanhope?
My point is that I could call the police. But that would only distress Mrs. Gluckman. I don't want to do that. So I won't. As long as the marriage is annulled and you agree to leave here right now and never come back.
Well, that's an interesting proposition, Stanhope, but why would I want to go along with that? Effie loves me.
No! No, that's the deal.
and I've said all I intend to say.
Well, what can I say, Stanhope? You win. Go ahead. Shoot me. Come on, Stanhope. Shoot me. La 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 la. No.
Isn't this lovely?
Oh, thank you. Well, here's to luck and love. May our passion last forever.
Oh.
What's the matter?
I don't like red wine. It's too bitter.
Oh, have just a little for me.
Yes, all right. I'm sorry, Howard. I didn't mean to be difficult.
Oh, I know you didn't, sweetie pie. To you. And here's to us.
Howard, you're trying to get me drunk, aren't you? Ooh. In that case...
Yes. Yes, I'd like an ambulance, please. It's my wife. Well, she went into convulsions, and I think...
She staggered to the stairs. And I tried to stop her, but she fell. Please hurry. I think she's dead.
Yeah, I'd like to book a first-class ticket on tonight's flight to Ascension. Ascension? E-S-C-U-N-S-I-O-N. Ascension, whatever. Howard Prince. Is that a nonstop flight? Good. And how much will that be? Uh-huh. No, I'll be paying cash. Thank you.
Sense. The last thing I expected was another note. So here I am. Now, what's the point of all this? What's the problem?
It's a nice touch meeting here like this, but it doesn't exactly scare me.
Maybe I wasn't trying to scare you.
Well, you want a piece of the action, huh? Is that what this is all about?
I've been here for 12 years, never seen anything like it.
What are you, a cop? Is that what I'm dealing with here?
No, I'm not a cop. I can't tell you how awe I am. All those ladies, so grateful for one last taste of life. What do you do to them? What do you say? I don't want them to get a hold of you. I wanted you to teach me.
Them? Who's them? What is this, a conspiracy?
Get it? They want you. They used me to bring you here
Christ, if you could just hear them begging me.
What the fuck are you talking?
Shit, man, they're coming for you. Run!
There's a penalty for wasting my time. No!
I got good news for you, Effie. You're gonna have company for all eternity. Hey, where'd she go?
I'm over here, Howard. I'm so glad you came.
Effie?
I've missed you.
Me too, Howard.
Matilda?
We couldn't live without you.
And we can't die without you.
Now that's what I call a happy ending. I had a feeling Effie would win Howard's heart, not to mention his spleen, his kidneys, and his gallbladder. So, will there be anything else? I love a ghoul who gives you head and then lets you keep it.